Because the baker had lost his mother and father in a baking accident, well, at least that's what he believed, he was eager to begin a family of his own and was concerned that all efforts until now had failed.
Who could that be?
We've sold our last loaf of bread.
It's the witch from next door.
Oh.
We have no bread!
Of course you have no bread.
What do you wish?
It's not what I wish. It's what you wish. Nothing cooking in there now, is there?
The old enchantress explained to the couple that she had placed a spell on their house.
What spell?
In the past, when you were no more than a babe, your father brought his young wife and you to this cottage. They were a handsome couple, but not handsome neighbors. You see, your mother was with child, and she had developed an unusual appetite. She took one look at my beautiful garden, and she told your father that what she wanted more than anything in the world were greens, greens, and nothing but greens. Parsley, peppers, cabbages, and celery, asparagus, and watercress, fiddlefin, and lettuce, he said, all right. But it wasn't quite as I caught him in the autumn in my garden one night. He was robbing me, raping me, rooting through my rutabagas, braiding my arugula, and ripping up the rampion, my champion, my favorite. I should have laid a spell on him right there. I could have turned him into stone, or a dog, or a chair. But I left it there. I want to spell. In return, however, I see fair is fair. You can let me have the baby that your wife will bear. And we'll call it Square.
I had a brother.
No. But you had a sister.
But the witch refused to tell him any more of his sister. Not even that her name was Rapunzel. She went on.
I thought I had been more than reasonable, and that we all might live happily ever after. But how was I to know what your father had also hidden in his pocket? You see, when I inherited that garden, my mother warned me that I would be punished if I were ever to lose any of the beans.
Beans?
The special beans. I let him go. I didn't know he'd taken my beans. I was watching him crawl right over the wall when bang, crash, the lightning flash. Yeah, well, that's another story. Never mind. Anyway, at last the big day came. I made my claim all to take away the baby. They shrieked and shrieked, but I did, and I hid her where she'll never be reached. Your father cried, and your mother died. But for extra measure, I admit it was a pleasure. I said, sorry, I'm still not mollified, and I laid a little spell on them. You too, son. That your family tree would always be a barren one. So, there's no more fuss and there's no more seeds and my garden thrives. You should see my nectarines, but I'm telling you the same I tell kings and queens. Don't ever, never, ever mess around with my greens. Especially the beans.